Ashley Kimbel is one of the most inventive people in the nation. She came up with an extraordinary innovation using a 3D printer, all while she was still in high school. Check it out.
We've all used our home printers for invitations, movie tickets. Sometimes we might even go as far as a glossy photo. But did you know 3D printers can create entire objects practically out of thin air? Today I'm in Palo Alto to track down Ashley Kimbel, a resourceful innovator who's using technology to change people's lives. Oh, and get this, she's only 17.
Hey, Ashley.
Hey, how are you?
I'm great, thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here.
So you just graduated?
Yeah, I just graduated and I'm gonna be attending UAB in the fall.
What are you gonna study?
Biomedical engineering.
Wow, biomedical engineering?
Ashley discovered her love of engineering in the seventh grade when she got involved in the Green Power Team, which challenges kids to design single-seat electric race cars. Now she's taken her passion for design and giving it a 3D twist.
These are 3D printers. Very cool technology that is basically printing, but in the third dimension. So it's based on the idea that you can print an object by building layer by layer.
Ashley shows me that she can print anything from phone cases to dog bowls. But you can use a 3D printer in many life-changing ways.
So are these some of the 3D printed objects?
Yeah.
Is that a heart I see over there?
It is.
Whoa.
They can take the scan from an MRI, upload it into the software, and actually print somebody's heart. So this heart is a diseased heart that surgeons actually used to go in and practice and explore before they actually went and did the real surgery on the person.
Ashley was so inspired by the work of biomedical engineers that she used her printer to change the life of a military veteran forever. During his service in Afghanistan, Kendall Bain was wounded and had to have his leg amputated at the knee.
The coolest thing I've ever done was a prosthetic foot that I built and designed for an amputee veteran.
What were the results?
We had great results. The first time he put it on, he went, okay, at least you got the height right. And we're like, okay, that's a start. And then he ran on it and it worked perfectly.
Now he can do all the things that he wants to do. That's a beautiful story.
It's clear 3D printers have some pretty important powers, but do they know how to have fun?
What are we looking at right now?
So you're looking at a 3D design of a glider.
So you designed this and then created a 3D object, a glider, just from this design here.
Yeah.
What?
So basically what this is a 3D CAD program.
CAD stands for Computer Aided Design, which basically just means that you're using a computer to design anything using simple geometry. You draw squares and circles, the software takes over and literally fills in the blanks, taking something from two dimensions to three. It's called extruding. CAD software is very commonplace, and it's free for students to use. It's so simple. Ashley started with this program when she was in the eighth grade.
And here you're creating the design and sending those instructions.
Yeah.
Well, can we print this thing?
Yeah, of course. We can send it over right now.
Yes.
Go. All right, let's go.
This type of 3D printer uses a process called multi-jet fusion. These printers heat an entire chamber of powder and shoot a fusing agent through it with incredible accuracy. In the places where the agent touches the powder, more heat is absorbed, which makes the powder stick together.
There it is, mission unstoppable. Sweet, oh man. Should we test this baby out?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right.
I feel the need for 3D speed.
Want to make this a competition and see who can go further?
You're on.
All right. Three,
two, one.
Launch!
Woo!
Hey! Oh! Was that mine?
I think it was.